morning, everybody. Norma here. How are you? Welcoming you to your Wednesday morning. So hello. It is Wednesday, August the 25th. I am outside again this morning at home. I do have my dog, Serafina, with me. And as you may have noticed, if you're here already, she's just drank out of my water glass. So I'm going to just move that to the side. And she does have a spot to lay down. But if she becomes too distracting, I'll put her back in the house. It is a beautiful morning here in Caledonia. We have been having those few hot days. Thank you, Serafina, lots of love. And just a gentle reminder, if you have not brought a strap with you to your mat, we are going to need a strap for our practice today. So if you need to go run and get it, please do so. If you don't have a yoga strap at home, you can use the robe belt or a tie if you have ties in the home. Just something that's not too silky or satiny that may slip off your floor. Good girl. Okay, maybe she can stay outside. And just a few reminders as we practice. This is more of a yin-inspired practice this morning. There will be a few flows. So I thought it would be a nice change of pace just to use a prop a little bit, maybe hold stretches a little bit longer, and not demand too much of our nervous system this Wednesday morning. So it is just 1 minute out. So if you have arrived, welcome. Posture this morning. I'm sitting up on a block, or actually it's my meditation pillow. So if you have any tightness in your hips, like I do, elevating your seat on a folded blanket or block or a pillow just gives you that little extra height, and it just lets the pelvis sit more correctly, and your knees should be lower than your hips. So let's begin. So welcome. We're starting in a seated position this morning, which we don't do a lot of the time, so just changing things up a wee bit. So if you feel like you need to be grounded this morning, you need to receive more grounding, you can flip your palms to the surface of your knees. That just gives you a little bit more connection to earth, gives you a little bit more grounding sensation. Or if you feel that you need to receive this morning, you can flip your palms up. So bowing our heads, lowering our gaze, or you can close your eyes if that feels okay. Let's begin to arrive. That you need to get comfy in this posture. And if it feels absolutely awful, maybe you just stretch out your legs if you have any knee issues. Let's bring that inhale breath together in through our nose. Open your mouth, sigh, let it all go. Can you slowly begin to arrive here? So over these next few breaths, checking things out. How are you feeling this Wednesday morning? Doing that quick body scan as your breath brings you back home here. Starting at the top of the head, relaxing your eyebrows, letting any number 11s that may have come up here, a frown, let it go. As you pass by the nose, maybe observing that breath entering your nose, feel the warmth there. And as you travel to your mouth, your lips in a smile, letting the biting surfaces of your teeth relax. Traveling down to your throat, making sure that you're not hyperextending your neck or crunching in, making sure that you have that nice opening in your throat, allowing the breath to do its magic as it travels through your body, allowing yourself to settle here, observing your shoulders. Maybe they've crept up and you didn't even know they crept up. Can you let them lengthen down your back and soften? See how that opens up your chest as we do that. Traveling to your belly now, to your solar plexus first, and then your sacral chakra we talked about last week, and finally the root. Maybe just imagining that breath going in and out. In and out, with the opportunity to settle here. The breath is a great way to bring yourself back, to regulate your nervous system. And it's a great opportunity for a brand new fresh start. So as we practice our flow, or our yin posture is holding on a little bit longer today, using that breath to bring you back to that moment, that present time. And your mind will wander, and that's okay. Just acknowledging that thought, bringing your attention back to your breath, and starting once again. Let's take one more inhale through the nose. Exhale, sigh, let it all go. Nice job. Slowly waking up our body, can you invite your chin to your chest? And coming back to center. One more time, chin to chest. Looking over your right shoulder, changing nothing in your shoulder or your upper body. Just moving the neck. Coming back to center and looking over your left shoulder. And back to center. One more time, each side, slow and steady. Back to center. One more time. Left shoulder. Just allowing your neck to move naturally. Breathing breath into any area that may be saying, I need some extra attention this morning. And back to center. If you are sitting on a block or a pillow, can you remove that now? Taking your hands to your knees. Can you round out your spine, curling in to a seated cow posture? Exhaling, weaving through that cat. Sitting tall in your seat, let's do that two more times. Curling in, cow. And exhaling, breathing through that cat. Bringing your chin up. Time with your own breath, linking breath with movement. Sorry about that, German Shepherd. Very protective, so must have heard something. Thank you, Serafina. And coming back to center. Can you take your right hand to the mat, flat on the mat, breathing your left arm up, sitting still tall in your seat. Can we inhale to lengthen and exhale? Coming over to the right side of your mat. You can bend into your elbow here if you've got the space, or you can come right down on your elbow if that's in your practice. And I again, observing how you're feeling this Wednesday morning. And you can invite a flow here if you want. Coming back to center, taking our left hand down now, breathing right hand up. Inhaling and exhaling over to the right side, left side of your mat. Breathing back to center. This is where the flow comes in. Right hand comes down, left hand comes up. Reaching over to left side. Breathing back to center. Inhaling to lengthen. Last time, left side. Breathing yourself back to center. Taking your hands back to your knees. Left hand comes to right knee, reaching right hand back behind you on your tented fingers. Inhaling to lengthen out of your seat, twisting your heart and chest from your waist over to the right side of your mat. Making sure you're breathing here. Untwisting, letting right hand come to left knee, and just twisting open to reset your spine to the left side, and coming back to center. This time, right hand comes to left knee, left hand is behind you, on tented fingers. Can we inhale to lengthen, sitting tall in our seat, exhale, twisting open to the left side of your mat here. And you can walk your fingers out if you want to get a little deeper into the stretch or a little further back behind you. Not compromising anything in your seat or your breath if you're going there. Breathing ourselves back to center. Uncrossing our feet, our legs, taking our feet together in this cobbler's posture. So letting your knees fall open naturally. And you can just take your feet as close to your seat as you want to, but also aware that we are still warming up here. So you can invite your feet out further if that feels more comfortable and allows you to feel more freer in the opening of your legs. Taking our peace fingers, grabbing onto our big toes. Can we inhale to lengthen and exhale, pouring our heart forward. Maybe you've got the move to the room to offer your elbows to your knees, inviting a little bit more opening here. Making sure we're not writing up the spine. We're long in our seat, pouring our heart forward. And breathing. That breath in through your nose and out through your nose. Just that little snoring quality, that ujjayi breath here that allows us to send breath into areas, regulates our system, brings our awareness back to our breath. Letting that go, sitting back up, closing your knees like a book, and maybe shaking your legs off before finding your way onto your mat, onto your hands and knees and your tabletop. And if you've got your strap, if you could just have that ready towards the top of the mat for you. So tucking our toes, lifting our hips up and back to our first downward facing dog. So pedaling our feet out here. First inversion, further warming up our legs. Bending your knees, looking to the top of the mat, can you travel there? You can take a big step, you can tippy toe, or you can jump there. Inhaling to lengthen, exhale, folding in. Beautiful. Rising all the way up. Taking hands to heart center and letting our hands come freely to the side in our Tadasana, our mountain pose here. Feeling that connection of our mat, our feet. Maybe take your toes all the way off the mat and letting one toe come down one at a time. And feeling that connection to your mat, much like we do when we're in our downward dog, feeling that finger connection, feeling that mat connection, being an opportunity to feel grounded here and welcome you back home to your yoga mat. Can we inhale our breath all the way up one more time, this time sitting back in your chair, hands could be heart center, and bowing all the way in. Can we inhale to lengthen, exhale, planting our hands, stepping back into our first flow, our Chaturanga Tadasana. So high or low plank, I often start on my knees for that first one, making sure your elbows are covering into your body. If you lower down, letting your breath, let your shoulders and chest come off the mat to your little baby cobra here, tucking your toes, going back up to your downward facing dog. Always an option to travel through table on your way there. Can you bring your right leg up behind you, looking forward, stepping your right foot to the top of the mat, letting our left foot come in on a 45, breathing hands up, warrior one. So closed hip posture for our warrior one, hips are forward, foot is on that 45, heel is flat on the mat, both feet. If that's making you feel unsteady in your stance, you can just step your left foot out a little bit here. And letting your hands come down, right foot meets left, rinsing that out with your Chaturanga Dandasana. I'm gonna stay on my toes now. Breathing hard up once again. Baby cobra, downward facing dog. Letting your left leg breathe up behind you, looking forward, stepping or helping your left foot to the top of the mat. This time taking our right foot off to the 45, breathing up, warrior one. Feeling our breath begin to quicken a little bit as we're warming up, letting hands come down, framing our foot. One more time, left foot meets right, rinsing it out. Shining your heart forward, downward facing dog. Bending your knees, travel to the top of your mat. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale, folding in. Sit back in your chair. Standing up, mountain pose. Siri Namaskar B, Sun Salutation B. It's a little different. Warm up this morning. Hope you're feeling maybe a little surprised at where we were going. Maybe enjoying some different postures. Can we inhale, shining everything forward. Bring that back to your heart. One more time, inhaling. This time bowing over your soft knees. Inhale to lengthen, plant your hands. Can you take your left foot long behind you? Taking hands to hip, or if you want to stay down into your low crescent lunge, you can go there. Breathing hands up if you're in your high crescent lunge, gaze can follow. So we're high on our tippy toes on that left foot. Right knee is bent. Nice, the chest moves. We take our hands into cactus arms here. So we're opening up our chest here, elbows stay at shoulder height. Can you inhale to prepare? Exhale, bring your hands together. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale, closing in. Inhale, lengthening, open up. One more time, breathing hands together. And shining back open. Letting hands come to your hips, pivoting on your feet. So you're facing forward, long edge of your mat. We're gonna reach for our straps. So we're in a wide-legged forward stance here. We're taking our strap or our tie or our belt in our hands. And you wanna clasp it lightly. We don't wanna have that death grip on our strap or our tie so that it just kind of negates what we're doing, right? So soft wrist to your strap. And you wanna have it wide enough that we're gonna floss out our shoulders here. So what that means is that we're gonna take our arms overhead and behind our back. If you have anything going on in your shoulders, you want to make sure you have a nice, long, wide pull to your strap, especially getting started. So knees are soft here. We're going to breathe up and letting the exhale bring your mat back, your strap to the back of your waist. Inhaling all the way up. Elbows shouldn't be locked here. Exhaling, coming forward. So if that's feeling real easy to you, maybe you bring your hands in a little bit closer together, but only if it doesn't change anything in your mobility or your breath. Let's do that again. Inhaling. And exhaling. Inhaling. Rising up. Exhaling. One more time. Inhaling. And exhaling. Beautiful, guys. You can let your strap fall gently in front of you. We're going to travel towards the back of our mat now. Left toes are forward. You can take your hands to your hips to help you navigate there. We're turning onto our right toes now. Settling into our warrior, our high crescent lunge on second side. So high on those tippy toes, bending generously into your left knee. Can you breathe your hands up again? Going back into the cactus arms. This time, we're going to inhale to lengthen and exhale. Can you just gently come back into a little baby back bend here, making sure our shin remains humble. We don't want to extend our nails, so imagine that grapefruit underneath your chin. You can invite some movement here if that feels okay. You can come out of it a little bit with your inhale and maybe exhaling, making sure that you're still breathing here. Making sure our rib cage is closed. You don't want to flail open your ribs. That's doing nothing to your posture or your alignment here. Always remember good alignment. Coming back to our breath. And coming back to center. Taking hands back to our hips. Pivoting back to the long edge of your mat. We're going to take our strap once again in our hands. This time the strap's going to be behind us to start. And we're going to inhale to lengthen. Exhale, pouring forward into your wide-legged forward fold, letting your strap gently allow your hands to come up long behind you. Maybe you have the space to have your hands come right overhead. Letting that heaviness of your head draw you further down. strap bow, taking your tented fingers in front of you. Can you inhale to lengthen? Exhale, folding in. Walking our fingers over to our right foot, grabbing onto ankle or pant leg. Breathing right hand up and open. Just wide legged forward fold with a twist. Letting that come down. Shelving over to our left leg now. You've got it. Right hand comes to our pant leg or our ankle. Inhaling to lengthen. Exhale, twisting open to the left side now. Making sure nothing's changing in your hips. Your knees are still soft. Letting left hand come down, walking back to center, inhaling to lengthen one more time before folding in, maybe grasping your opposite elbows here in a ragdoll. Big, 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 generous bend to your knees as you just let everything hang here. Unclasping the ragdoll, letting your breath bring you back up one more time. This time bringing your right toes in front, taking a big step, left foot meets right. Inhaling to lengthen, exhale, folding in one more time before rising all the way up to stand, clasping your hands, letting your pointed fingers reach up. So inhaling to lengthen, exhaling, pouring yourself over to the right side of your mat. Maybe observing any changes here from this seated stretch, first of class. And again, if you want any movement here, coming out a little bit on the inhale and then exhaling, see if you can go a little further. Only if that doesn't change anything, your breath. Want to challenge your posture just for a moment, maybe coming up on your tippy toes, exchanging the weight into your right foot, or maybe taking that left foot up just for a moment. Letting left foot come down, bringing yourself back to center, shaking your arms up. Inhaling once again, this time chasing the clasp of your fingers. It feels different, doesn't it? Inhaling to lengthen, your pointed fingers are still up, rising up, leading the way. Lengthening with your inhale and exhaling, coming over to the left side of your mat now. Feeling that nice stretch on the right side of your body. Same breath there. And invite any movement here that you want to engage, just incorporating that flow. Inhaling to come out, exhaling, seeing can you get a little bit more space there. Always awareness that one side may be completely different than the other, and that's okay. Adjusting our balance here, if you want to transition your weight over to your left foot, right tippy toes come up, maybe you lift your right foot right off the mat. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, letting right foot come down if it was lifted, left breath, brings your arms back to center. Can we swan dive all the way down? Inhaling to lengthen, exhale, stepping back to our final vinyasa. Hello, Serafina. Rinsing it all the way out. Maybe coming into an upward dog if that's in your practice. Downward facing dog. Three breaths here. Bending your knees, traveling to the top of your mat. I forgot. forgot one little thing, guys, and I didn't want you to feel left out here. Not that you knew it was coming. Can we inhale to lengthen one more time? Exhale, sitting back in our chair, because I know everybody loves chair posture. So in your chair posture, can you make sure that your shoulders are long on your back? We're gonna twist in our chair this morning. So with the inhale to lengthen, exhale, twisting over to the right side of your mat. Maybe you have the space to hook your left elbow to your right knee. Not necessary. If you want to challenge yourself just a little bit here, can you take your left foot long behind you into this lunge twist? Keeping that twist, can you step your left foot back to meet right if you're in your lunge twist? Coming back to center for a breath, holding on, don't let it go. Twisting over to the left side of the room now. Holding into that chair. And one more time, if you want to challenge yourself, stepping right foot back, long behind you, into this lunge twist. You can. Two more. Keeping your twist, if you lengthen, stepping right foot to meet left. Going back to center now, dumping it all out. Good job, guys. Inhaling to lengthen. Exhale, I'm gonna throw one more vinyasa in because I like to flow. If you want to settle into your child's pose, go for it, because that's where we're going to meet. Nice job. See, doesn't that feel better, getting that chair twist in? So in your child's pose, letting yourself settle here. Breathing breath into your back body, letting your hips sink towards your heels. And more breaths, maybe getting a drink of water. Getting a cleansing breath. If anything comes up, you want to let go of. Pulling your heart rate down. Maybe it's bringing your attention back to your breath. If your mind can't wander here. And when you feel ready, pushing yourself up to a seat. Once again, clasping your strap. And we're going to come all the way down onto our back. So letting our feet come up flat on the floor, can you loop your strap over the ball of your foot? Your foot can, the strap is in both hands here. And once again, just like before, don't have that tight grasp on it. It should be a light grip. And you shouldn't be shrugging your shoulders or your neck up here after we've stretched everything out. So can we invite our right foot towards our nose? And you can keep your foot on the mat here, your left foot bent, or you can extend your left foot long, foot is flexed. Honoring your body. We're gonna hold these stretches just for a little bit longer. Making sure there's a slight bend to your right knee. Not looking anything out. Letting the strap do its work, getting a little deeper into your stretch. Letting the strap come over into your right hand. You can take your left hand out for support on the left side. Can you let your right foot fall open like a book to the right side of your mat? Making sure you're anchoring through the shoulder of your left side. Nothing's changing there. What is flexed? Both feet. Slap micro bend to the right knee. Just observe, are you holding on anywhere here? Can you let go and relax here for 10 breaths? Your breath, bring your right foot back to center, taking the strap now into your left hand. Right hand comes to the right side of your body. Can you invite your right leg stacking right hip on top of left, twisting over to the left side. And awareness once again, engaging that right shoulder, making sure it's not lifting off the mat. You can gaze over that right shoulder. Twisting open to the left side of the mat. Allowing your breath to lead the way. Sending it to any area that may be calling for a little bit of tension here, especially as we did a few chair postures today. Come back to center, letting the strap come down just for a minute, having both feet on the mat one more time. Maybe you just windshield wipe through your knees from side to side to reset before we start second side. So starting once again, feet are flat, taking the strap for your tie or your belt over the ball of your left foot, clasping it with both hands right now. And can we invite our left foot towards our nose? Keep your foot flat on the floor, or you can stretch along in front of you. Still in micro bend to that left knee. And keep your knee bent if that's causing any issues in your back. Letting our strap come into our left hand now, letting right hand come out for balance, letting that left foot fall open to the left side of your mat, foot is flexed, making sure that right shoulder is still anchored here. Holding on to nothing here. Can you soften even more? can. Serafina. Sorry, guys. Let me get your anchoring into your left shoulder. Can you let your left foot open up to the left side, right side of your mat? Sorry, guys. Keep going. I'm going to put her inside. Sorry about that. Stacking left hip on top of right this time as we twist open to the right side of your mat. Good thing that didn't start in our shavasana. So engaging that left shoulder, making sure it's anchored into the mat. Maybe you take your gaze over your left shoulder. Your eyes can be closed here. Noticing any difference that one side may be than the other. Always awareness, never judgment. And your breath there. And with your breath, can you soften any more? Maybe you weren't aware that you may have been holding on there. Letting yourself come back to center, letting go of your strap. Thank you, strap, for helping us getting a little deeper into those postures, letting your feet come down to the mat, and maybe engaging those windshield wipers a few times just to feel the spaciousness in your hips that you've created, resetting our spine. Before offering stillness, taking ourselves up, head and shoulders come up to a little hug, knees into chest. Before coming down, feet flat on the mat again, taking feet together like a book, just like we started in that seating position, this reclined cobbler's posture, anchoring heart and belly. One more restorative posture before we settle into our shavasana. So you can stay here for your shavasana if this feels nice and cozy here, or if you want to settle into a traditional shavasana posture, letting your feet open wide to the edges of your mat, letting hands come out to your sides, allowing your armpits to air out from all that hard work that you did, tucking your shoulders under slightly to open up your heart. Enjoy this last few minutes of rest and relaxation, knowing when the time is right, I will be here to bring you back. Remember that you are water. Cry, cleanse, flow. Remember that you are fire. Burn, ignite, tame. Remember that you are air. Be still, focus, decide. Remember that you are earth, ground, fills, and give. Slowly bringing your awareness back to your body, back to your breath. Maybe inviting the light into your eyes as you slowly invite small movements to your body. Maybe massaging out the back of your head, turning towards one ear and then the other. Before pushing yourself back up slowly over to one side or the other, nothing rushed. Before coming back to center, bringing hands to heart center. Anjali Mudra, taking this moment to close your eyes if that feels okay, or soften your gaze, chin is humble here. Taking a moment to observe your body, noticing any changes that your practice may have brought to your heart, your mind, or your body. Acknowledging that you are your own best teacher, and thanking yourself for carving out this time for yourself to do the flows, do the stretches, and remember who you are. It has been my honor to guide you in your practice this morning. Know that the love and the light in my heart bows to the love and the light in your heart. Namaste. Enjoy your day, everybody. Stay cool. Thank you. We're in for another hot one. I am on vacation next week, but I hope to be able to tape a class and post to you. So there's something for you to enjoy for yoga next week. I'm sure that Diane and Laurel will be on the schedule too, as their schedule allows. And just remember, these are always available on YouTube. If you need any help in finding us on YouTube, you can always call Divi or myself or any of the wellness team. So have a great day, and thanks for coming out. Namaste.